You know what, so you know what said to get out the room? What did the lawyer say to the other lawyer?
Yes.
I have no idea.
We are both lawyer.
Who you really are eventually comes out in what you say, in what you do.
As the devil is coming into your life and he's taking away the blessing. You are sitting here this morning, you are disregarding what I'm saying, the word of God, you are distracted, you are careless, you are sleeping. The devil is actually doing more work in your life this morning than all of you. And that's the spirit of God. Maybe things you're distracted about, maybe evil thoughts, maybe personal pride. Maybe you don't need this message, maybe it's a carelessness of God. But whatever it is, the devil is using you to do a work in your life. So Jesus.
And that night, I went home and talked to my mom, and I accepted God's free gift of salvation. And afterwards, I was really excited for a little while. But as I grew older, I didn't really make time to read my Bible. I didn't really go to church that often because I didn't feel like it. I would pray, but my prayers would be almost like mechanical and like the same thing every time just because I felt like I had to do it.
Do not be conformed to the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may by testing discern what is the will of God, what is good, acceptable, and perfect. Some of you might be saying, the home that I come from, the school that I'm in, if I would be the only one that's different, then it's just too hard. It's just too complicated. Well, let me say this. If you're going to make pure decisions, holy decisions, decisions that are pleasing to God, and live in the best place in your life where you can experience the joy and fulfillment of a relationship with God each day,
sure, were you saved before?
I got saved on Sunday.
You got saved? Oh my gosh, that's great. High five.
Right.
Yeah. Wow.
You got saved too, Cody? Oh my gosh, I love you.
How's it going?
Hi, I'm Tiffany. Well, last year I came to the Word of Life camp and I got saved, gratefully, thank the Lord. But I got home and I started living a double life and I've been struggling with that a lot. I went to the family campgrounds about 2 weeks ago, and we stayed there for 2 weeks, and I had such an amazing time, and I got to know so many new people, and it was such a blast. But I realized when I got home, I live for God when I'm around godly people, but not when I'm around my other friends in my home, because I grew up in a non-Christian home with non-Christian parents, so it's been really hard going home and they're not there, and worrying that if they die that they're not going to go to heaven. And it scares me. And the last night we had a drama and I talked to this girl and she sat there and prayed with me because I don't want to go back home and be that other person living a double life and going back home and doing the bad things that I've always done. If I could, I would stay here forever because it's so amazing and I love being around other kids and people that are godly. And I just think I've had such an amazing time here at camp and I don't want to go home because it really is amazing and God's changing my life. I met one of my old friends who she wasn't godly at all. She used to be bad and everything. And I saw her this week at camp and she's so much better. And she was preaching to me about the gospel the other day and I was preaching to her about it. And I really hope that a lot of other people learn to let God into their heart because he does amazing things. He's changed my life so much and I've been praying that he changes me even more so that I can go home and be that godly person when I'm not here and when I'm not around godly people and help share the gospel to my friends who aren't saved.
who you are. People don't know you.
I'm JJ Dre. No one really knows me. But I actually got saved when I was 5. I lived in a Christian home, but I kind of got hard to Christianity when I got older. I got into some like bad stuff in middle school, doing my own thing. And I hit my 9th grade year, and I wasn't doing too well either in 9th grade year. But actually last summer, I started to get into his word, and I really started getting back into Christ. I went to the island, and I just really enjoyed it, and that's where I stick in the fire. I was all excited about like spreading the gospel, and then I went back to school. I go to a Christian school, but no one's really Christian, and so I was trying to like share the gospel and stuff in my school, but it wasn't really working out, and I went back to doing what I was doing. And so this summer, actually, I would say I really started sharing the word. I would just go up to people and I just start talking to them, even if I didn't know them. And it's been a really good thing. I'm having a fun time at camp. I met a lot of people for the good. And I'm just excited to learn more in God's word. And I'm planning to go to Africa next summer, so that'll be fun. And I'll preach the word there. So, yeah.